Okay, after this, we will hear the opening remarks from the Director of Academic Affairs, IFME International Business School, Ms. Yulita Susanti, PhD. Ms. Yulita, the screen is yours.
Thank you so much, Fikri, for giving me the opportunity to give the opening remark for today enrichment class. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dear attendees, everyone and everyone who is coming for this event, I would like to say thank you because this is very good opportunity for everyone to learn about the financial planning. All right, so I'm very proud, yes, to announce that this event is a collaboration between all stakeholders of IPMI. Yeah, the first one is we have Innovation Lab, and then we have the IPMI under IBBA program. And we still have our student who will be the facilitator for today. We have Vincent Jonas. He is the IPMI student batch 2018. He's so active as the part of IPMI Investment Gallery. And so we have Abdurrahman Wahid, and also IPMI batch 2018. He's also part of the investment gallery, but also Wahid is also part of the IDX relation executive. And next, we have our alumni. Yes, Isfan Helmi, IPMI BBA 2009, who's now working as the head of research for OCBC Sekuritas Indonesia. But also we have our very prominent faculty. Especially right in finance, we have the one and only Professor Roy Semble. Okay, give big applause to Professor Roy Semble. All right. So this event actually is very important because this part is be sharing. Yes, our activity today is focusing on the finance. Yeah, financial planning that we share to the public about our knowledge on everything, our expertise, to see that how IPMI could do something for the society. So this one is this event is like we done it several times. Yes, it's conducted by IPMI undergraduate program. I would like to say thank you as well to Ibu Lintanello and Bapak Sasetya Pratama, and also for IPMI team who support fully this event, to the BBA students, to Fikri Yuda that always available, yeah, as the MC for mostly IPMI events. All right, so please enjoy this event. So this is good because the topic is about the financial independence for early retirement. So well, I don't know what do you think about this, but this is good, right? If you could retire early, but the money work for yourself. So please take this opportunity to learn more, and you so you could ask many questions, yes, to our expert and also to the students, as they also supporting our investment gallery. Okay, enjoy the event. All right, good luck. Thank you so much for your attendance again. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you so much for the wonderful remarks, Ms. Yulita. Before we start, let me inform you about our agenda today. First agenda will be the lecturing session with Professor Roy Semble, MBA, PhD, then continue with the student sharing session with Kak Abdurrahman Wahid, IDX Relation Executive of IPMI Investment Gallery, and Kak Vincent Jonas, Securities Company Relation Executive of IPMI Investment Gallery. Last but not least, there's a guest speaker session with Mr. Isfan Helmi, BBA, Head of Research, OCBC Sekuritas Indonesia, and the last is the Q&A session. Now to all of the participants, please turn on your camera for the photo session. Kak Nyimas will help us to take the picture. Please, can you pass?
Okay, there are two slides. I will count 1, 2, 3. All right. Please turn on your camera. 1, 2, 3. Look at the camera. Okay, one more slide. Wait. 1, 2, 3. Okay, done. Back to Fikri.
Okay, thank you so much, Kanyimas, for helping us. Now, we will enter our first session, which is a lecturing session that will be led by Professor Roy Sembo. Good morning, Prof.
Good morning.
Okay, you're looking energetic today, sir.
Thank you.
Prepare your notes without any further ado, Prof. The time and screen is yours.
Okay, can you see my slide, everyone?
Yes.
Okay, the topic is about financial independence, so you can retire early. Although the term retire itself may be different from many people, yeah. Because I don't want to be retired, for example, because I enjoy my work. I prefer to do my work because it is my hobby. That is not the retirement that I'm looking for, but the financial independence, gitu ya. Gitu, okay? So, I twist a little bit the topic. So, financial independence, not really retire as what we most people says, ya. Nah, begitulah ceritanya. So, here are the tips, ya. Okay, for those of you who still don't know me, my name is Roy Sembel. I'm the professor at IPMI International Business School. Part of my life is as the academician and the other part as a business practitioner. And these are all my books and these are my three sons and one my daughter is still taking a doctoral program in New York. Yeah, these are the three sons that are in Indonesia. They have their own business. Including the digital media business. If you have Instagram, you can check the Proud Point Project, Folix Media, and Volcative. That's example. Yeah. So I need to have an interaction with you. Before we start, my topic, please go to menti.com, yeah, Mentimeter, menti.com, and then answer this question. Apa yang muncul di benak Anda jika mendengar kata financial independence, ya? Yeah? Bentar, saya switch ke mana dia. Bentar, mana dia itu. Nah, ini dia. Okay, financial, ke menti.com ya. And here is the menti.com. Go ahead, go to menti.com. Jawab pertanyaan, apa kata yang muncul di benak Anda jika mendengar kata kebebasan finansial, financial independence, kemerdekaan finansial. Kodenya jadi www.menti.com, kodenya 8851-1825. Oke, go ahead. Come on, go to menti.com, and then the pin code is 8851-1825, ya, 8851-1825, dan jawab kata yang muncul, kata berkait nih, kalau dengar kata financial independence, kira-kira apa yang muncul di benaknya para audiensnya? Go ahead. Ada 15 orang yang mewakili audiens ini. Nah, dari sampel 15 orang kelihatan nih. The main word that comes to your mind when you see the word financial independence is freedom. Kalau zaman dulu ada lagunya Bon Jovi atau lagunya apa tuh? Pak Sas mungkin kenal ya. I want to break free. Nah, lagu apa tuh namanya tuh ya? Jadi freedom, freedom. Lagu.
Freddie Mercury.
Oh, Freddie Mercury. Oke. Okay. Anyway, this is freedom ya. Katanya muncul dengan kebebasan, freedom. Nah, oke. Okay. Good. Thank you very much for participate in the simple survey. The kata berkait dengan financial independence. Wow. Thank you. Prosperity. Apalagi tuh. Menghasilkan uang sendiri. Happiness. Ketenangan. Asik. Wealthy. Okay, very good. Apalagi. Jajan. Okay, good. Damai. Enough income. Debt free. Money work from us. Stock rich. Mantap deh. Okay, thank you ya. Saya balik lagi ke materinya. Itu yang ada di benak Anda semua ya, tentang financial independence. Oke, good. Nah, sekarang kalau bicara tentang financial independence, it relates to something. Of course, everyone will have their own concept about financial independence, as we saw in the Mentimeter. Tapi the main ideas that we will discuss here, more or less I will scope it somewhere here. Okay. Financial independence. Reducing risk, ya, jadi risiko akan diredam. And increasing value creation for financial with financial literacy, itu metodenya. And then to achieve your financial targets. And then yang penting juga nih, while enjoying the process. Tadi ada damai yang bagus tuh, bagus ya. Nah, pertanyaan berikutnya adalah what is financial literacy? Literacy, aduh salah ketik. Oke, okay. Literacy, financial literacy. What is financial literacy? It's about knowledge, skills, attitude, and behavioral related to finance. Creating and increasing wealth and managing the risk and enjoy all the process of it. Yeah? So see, relate very tightly with the concept of financial independence, my version anyway. Okay, jadi kalau di dalam bahasa yang sederhana, kecerdasan finansial adalah ini dia. Gitu ya. Silakan dibaca sendiri. Intinya adalah menciptakan kemampuan yang berkelanjutan dapat menikmati kemakmuran tersebut dan dalam jangka pendek, menengah dan panjang ya gitu ya. Check 1, 2, 3. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, Prof. Clearly.
Yeah. Sorry, hilang sebentar tadi ya. Oke, jadi inilah kira-kira definisi dari kecerdasan finansial ya. Nah, kemudian let's move on. So, when we talk about the financial literacy, itu lebih banyak tergantung pada what you do every day, your other Qs than IQ. Jadi bukan cuma intelligence quotient, ya kecerdasan yang IQ-nya sampai 190 atau berapa. However, it's what you do day by day, your emotional quotient, your creativity quotient, adversity quotient, etc. Ya. So, jadi lebih banyak tergantung dari your habit and less on your knowledge. Maybe knowledge, yes, open knowledge important, but the contribution is only about 10 to 15% lah maximum ya. Oke, okay. Jadi salah satu yang harus Anda lihat adalah Anda punya apa? What do you have? If you have a lot of asset, be careful. You have to split between those two category. That is a good asset. Jadi aset bagus, aset yang create value for you that in the future, you will receive the cash flow in the short run, medium run, or long run. Yeah. While the bad asset will reduce your wealth if you own and keep them. Yeah. So be careful. Asset may be good, maybe not good. Yeah. So even though you own something, doesn't mean that you will become rich because of what you own. Yeah. So be careful. Okay. So the tips is you have to develop your good asset, yeah, that's the important thing, yeah. Sometimes the bad asset because of the required by the law, for example, you cannot eliminate the asset, okay. However, you can cover the destructive effect of the bad asset by developing your good asset, yeah, so that at some point you can reach your financial independence, yeah. So can you can retire, whatever the definition of retire, itu early, yeah. However, the other side, you have the debt. Debt itself, some people say don't have debt. Tadi debt free ya. Nah, bukan berarti debt itu jelek. You have debt. If your debt is used to develop your good asset, that is good, yeah, because you can increase your speed to reach your targets, yeah, by using that good debt, utang yang bagus, to develop good asset, yeah. Yes, of course, there is a cost, ada biayanya utang. However, if the asset is good, then the result, the positive result of the asset will cover it even more. You get the, on top of that, the cost of the bad debt-nya. Nah, kalau ini debt kan, kalau debt kan dari kita nih ya, ya tergantung kitanya. Jadi, sedapat mungkin harus eliminate the bad debt. Because bad debt adalah debt, ya debt yang biayanya gede karena terdesak atau gimana, and parah lagi if it is used to develop the asset jeleknya, the bad asset, double trouble ya, sudah jatuh tertimpa tangga dipatok ayam, aduh ngeri banget. Okay, so how do you get your income? These are ways to get income ya, according to Robert Kiyosaki ya. So you can work for other people ya. Nah ini ya, you are employee ya. For example, I work for IPMI as a lecturer. I am the employee. Yeah. And then you can work for yourself. For example, if I become the trainer, yeah, the company called me to be a trainer. That is self-employed. I work for myself. Yeah. And if I own business, I hire people to work for me. That is the business. Yeah. Okay, the other people will work for me and create wealth for me. Yeah, of course, there's compensation for them. And then last but not least, your money work hard for you. Yeah, that is you are the investor, gitu ya. Okay, or you can do the combination of that. Yeah, gitu ya. So it is not only one quadrant that you can be in, only in one quadrant. Even you can be in four quadrant, yeah, consecutively. Yeah. All right. Nah, sayangnya for most investor, for that investor, most investor will experience the virus, the very dangerous virus, not COVID virus, but the virus called the Tigata. What is Tigata? This is, I will explain Tigata. Tigata is in bahasa Indonesia. When usually investor, the new investor, start investing in, for example, stock market. Usually, unfortunately, they will start when the price is already high. Because during the process here, there are many stories of many people making money from here to here, right? Well, in fact, it is already at the peak of the market. Yeah. And there are a lot of story here, and many new investors came to also participate because of this story. Yeah. Unfortunately, usually this is already the peak of the market. Yeah. That is the first time, that is tamak, buru-buru cepat retire early, cepat kaya tapi nggak mau belajar. Then after that, then the market will drop. The market will drop. Then the second emotion, takut. Then they sell. So it, instead of buy low, sell high, they buy high and sell low kan gitu. Dan tamat deh, beres deh. Nggak jadi kaya lah gitu ya. Nah, the serum is already there, 6B. Belajar. However, the belajar should be there is a stage ya. Belajar tentang produk investasinya, belajar tentang strateginya, belajar tentang marketnya, belajar dengan simulasi dulu supaya jangan hilang duit, kemudian belajar berinvestasi beneran bertahap, kemudian belajar mengendalikan emosinya. Kan kira-kira seperti itu. Okay. Nah, banyak kesalahan yang dilakukan the new investor based on the behavioral finance. These are all the things that you can learn. We will not discuss it one by one. It will take about several days to discuss one by one. But at least you can get an overview about it. In order to to reduce that possibility to make mistakes, you can use the technique, the tips called the wisdom, W-A-S-D-O-M. Start with way-nya, itu watak. You need to know yourself and then the opportunity and threat outside there. Strengths, weaknesses, opportunity and threat. That's the starting point. And then, what's your target? Yeah, that's impian atau ingin. Yeah. And then from the W to I, how to achieve the I, starting with the W, that is petakan strateginya. W-I-S is the plan. And then you develop yourself. Always belajar, belajar, belajar. That is capacity building for yourself. And then you implement what you learn. Ya, jadi jangan cuma belajar di awang-awang, tapi you have to implement. That is the O, otak, otot, dan orang. Eksekusi implementasinya dengan kerja cerdas otak, kerja keras otot, dan kerja sama orang. Ya. Last but not least, you do the M, matter, monitor, management. Of course, you have to measure the result compared to the plan. And you always monitor whether the result is more or less in line with the plan or there is a difference atau penyimpangan. Then you learn from your mistake and you build on your achievement. You manage your resources optimally gitu ya. Yeah, starting from W, that is starting point, and then the I is the objective. And then from W to I, you do the S, lewat mana nih naik ke puncak gunungnya. And then after you plan, then you develop yourself, latihan naik gunungnya dulu ya. Ya kerja keras untuk bisa kerja keras, kerja cerdas, kemudian naik gunungnya, you climb the mountain dengan kerja keras, kerja cerdas, kerja sama, and then last bonus di M, the matter, monitor, dan management ya. Okay, so investment is not only about trying to beat the market, but you need to work very, very hard nih. Ini belajarnya tadi, udah belajar, belajar, belajar. At IM International Business School, in my class, I also use that technique, that is the belajar yang nomor 4 tadi, belajar menggunakan simulasi. Ya. This is the example of the simple simulation in my class, the report something like this, yeah. And then the strategy of our age group, they have to define the strategy, dan perusahaan apa yang dipilih dalam strateginya ini, dan seterusnya. Ya. And then part of the investment strategy, the active investing versus the passive investing. Yeah, passive investing, if you believe in the market all on average, right, you just follow the passive investing. Otherwise, if you believe that you can beat the market, you can do the active investing, yeah, things like that. Okay, you have to use your left brain, that well-structured, but also your creativity, your right brain. That's the combination. You are blessed with two sides of the brain. Yeah, use optimally the combination of the left brain and the right brain. Okay, what you need to study in order to be an investor? Of course, you need to study the numbers, financial report, financial health, the overall industry sector, macro analysis, share valuation, technical analysis, variety of investment strategy. That is the, itu tadi yang belajar, belajar, belajarnya itu tiganya. Now, you form your portfolio, that is mesti yang nyaman dan makmur. Nyaman itu kalau cocok antara profile investornya dengan investment instrument. Makmur kalau cocok antara portofolionya dengan situasi perkembangan makronya dan industrinya. Kalau dikombinasi jadi nyaman dan makmur, asik. Tapi sumber dananya dari mana? You have to collect sumber dana yang efisien. Jadi artinya dari dikumpulkan dari hasil income Anda bulanan, disisihkan gitu, dari uang jajan disisihkan. Nah gitu, jadi jangan pakai pinjaman dari rentenir yang 50% per tahun, habis nanti duitnya gitu ya. Okay, this is also part of your retirement. You can mempercepat retirement-nya kalau you really want to retire, whatever your retirement. Intinya biasanya normalnya gini ya. Di sini sampai umur 20 tahun, 20 sampai 30 tahun, 30 40, 40 50, 50 60-an udah sampai sini tuh retire. Usually this is the pattern of the people life cycle ya. Yeah. But not always like this. If you want to do the other route, for example, you want to mempercepat retirement-nya dengan enggak perlu nunggu sampai atas ini, tahu-tahu udah duluan di sini, udah bisa sampai di sini, dan you have to practice. Itu tadi tips-tips yang di depan tadi ya. Oke, okay. Saya pikir dari saya cukup dulu sekian, udah kelewatan waktunya. So, silakan kembali kepada moderatornya gitu. Oke, okay. Dan ini ada final ini, takeaways-nya deh. Langsung ke takeaways saja, udah kelamaan ngomongnya. The takeaways is, kelihatan nih layarnya? Can you see my screen?
Yes, bro.
So, takeaway. Selalu waspada, nggak perlu panik meskipun krisis. Think balance, saat ini apa yang dikerjakan long termnya untuk pensiunnya gimana, retire. You should invest consistently if you want to retire early. Yeah. And the analysis should be fact-based tadi yang tadi belajar, dan you have to manage risk. And then tadi virus 3T dilawan dengan serum 6B dan gunakan wisdom-nya ya tadi. Kira-kira. So, terakhir ada the best 8H-nya, be hopeful and helpful. Hopeful karena banyak harapan ke depan, help saling menolong satu dengan yang lain, empower, heart, head, and kerja sepenuh hati, kerja cerdas, dan kerja keras. And stay hungry and happy. Hungry untuk selalu learning, belajar, 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 dan enjoy the process. Tadi kan selalu ada kata enjoy the process dalam financial, apa tadi, financial, kecerdasan finansial. Dan berkembangnya harus holistik, jadi nggak cuma belajar finance saja, harus belajar bisnisnya secara komprehensif. Dari segala sisi, finance, marketing, human capital, dan lain-lain. Makanya di IPMI, you will be trained to learn the business holistically, ya, dari kurikulumnya, nggak cuma satu sisi saja. So, utilize that opportunity to learn and enjoy the process, then stay hungry, gitu ya. Oke, saya tutup pakai pantun. Kalau jalan-jalan ke Tasikmalaya, jangan lupa enjoy sambal dan ngemil oncom. Masih ada yang ditanya, silakan kirim email ke roy.sambal@gmail.com. Dan makan siri di tepi perigi. Terima kasih, sampai jumpa lagi. Thank you very much. Kembali kepada moderatornya, Fikri Yuda. I'm done here. Thank you. Stop share.
Okay, thank you so much, Professor Roy Samuel, for the insightful session. As Prof. Roy mentioned before, that he is our financial professor. Also, currently he teaches a merger and acquisition class. I do believe every person who attends this webinar is want to know more about IPMI. We will show you video about IPMI. So let's take a look. I would like to tell you about what benefit that you will get if you join IPMI BBA program. First thing first, you will get knowledge from the expert practitioner lecture. Second, usage of English language in class will increase your English ability. And lastly, the case learning method from Harvard Business Case will sharpen your critical analysis thinking. Another thing, at IPMI we have a special program, which is a joint degree and exchange program. For the student committee, we have an investment gallery and InnoLab, Incubation and Innovation Center. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the BBA program class at IPMI International Business School. Next, let us hear a short information regarding BBA Pro class that will be delivered by Kak Ami. So Kak Ami, the time is yours, Kak.
Thank you, Fikri. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Ami, the recruitment from BBA professional class in IPMI. Now, I would like to inform you about our BBA professional class. As we know, our BBA professional class just opened. And for you guys who want to continue your study in our BBA professional class, you can join us in our BBA professional class. And then here is the qualification. You have to in 20 years old or more. And then you have to have work experiences or self-employed. And you are a high school degrees, or diploma graduated. And then you will study in our flexible time. And then transfer credit opportunity. And it will be studying in Bahasa Indonesia. So that's all from me. If you have any question, please contact me in person. The number is in the flyer. And get back to you, Fikri. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kak Ami, for the information. Okay, for your information, because you all have joined the enrichment class, you will get a golden ticket for free of tuition submission fee. However, don't forget to fulfill the feedback link that will be informed on the chat box. So, now, let's move to the next session. We have Kak Abdurrahman Wahid and Kak Vincent Yonas that will share to us about the investment gallery of IPMI International Business School. So, Kak Abdurrahman Wahid and Kak Vincent, now it's your turn.
Thank you, Fikri.
Thank you, Fikri.
Dan bisa kedengaran suara saya?
Bisa, Kak.
Oke, izin share screen ya. Oke, good morning everyone, participant. Let me introduce ourselves again. My name is Abdurrahman Wahid.
And my name is Vincent Rafael Yonas.
Okay, so this is just our profile and some quotes that will be interesting regarding this topic. So my quotes will be, work with your money. Don't let yourself be tired while your money is sitting around doing nothing. Artinya kan kita harus bekerja dengan uang kita, jangan sampai uang kita diem aja di bank atau di tabungan. Kita nanti supaya bisa dapat passive income.
Yes, and from me is you have to work hard when you still can or when you still able to work, because there will be a time when you can work as hard as this age. So make sure you use your time, because your time is also your asset. That's all me.
So we'll be sharing about our journey on investing and also what we get from learning at IPMI, also what we also get from IPMI Investment Gallery. So this is a quote from Warren Buffett. If you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. This is so relatable to the topic, as everyone want to retire early and have a security when we are retired. So Warren Buffett implicitly say that we need to have a passive income. So when we are already retired, we don't have we don't work, but we still have income that we hopefully can live a long life as him. So let's share about why we start investing. Maybe Vincent, you can go first.
Okay, as I have mentioned before, mainly there are every human have three main in the life on what is your age. For example, my age and why it's 20 to 25, and the energy, cash flow, mainly our parents, and I think that Wahid also starting some business, so I also start some small business, and we also earn.
Hello. Oh, Vincent disconnect, so I will take over. The reason why me start investing is started when I was in high school. I have a lot of tabungan from my allowance. I don't know what you to use it for. Many of my friends started doing business while I still don't have any business, and I was wondering what to do. I'm not the type who go out and drink coffee on above after school or hanging out with friends. My daily routine usually go to school, go to Bimbel, and then go home. And I have this money, and I was wondering what should I do. And it is, I saw a YouTube video regarding Warren Buffett and a lot of investment figure. So I started investing on stocks. So that's also because when you started investing, it's really important to learn. And at that time, it's hard even for a high school to learn about investing, but continue learning, especially at IPMI, improve my confidence in investing. Vincent?
Hello, everyone. I'm sorry for my bad internet connection. I'm sorry. And maybe I will continue why I start investing. just a couple of seconds. I start invest because I just want to use my assets to grow more assets, to earn more assets. So I will use my time and I will use my energy to grow more money, because I know I still have more time and my energy at my age. So how do I can get money? Jujur-jujurnya, at this age, I don't have so much money, but I want to have much money at this age. So I use my time and my energy to invest. And I choose stock market as my first instrument.
So why we start investing, maybe the audience can relate the situation that we have experienced, and it can be a motivation for you, for the participant to start investing. And this is five reasons why we invest in stock. The ability to earn regular passive income from dividend. As you all know, when you buy a stock, you buy the company. So if the company doing well and then they get profit, they will distribute, some company will distribute their net profit to us as a dividend. And it is more liquid investment compared to other option. Some of you probably have other investment, maybe real estate or gold or something, like a physical asset that you can, you are investing, but it takes time to sell the asset, especially if you investing in real estate. It will take time to find a buyer. Maybe if you sell under the market price, you will get the you will quickly sell your real estate. But in stock, it is liquid, so if you buy today and tomorrow you need to sell it, you definitely can sell tomorrow. And the ability to start with a small amount of fund, as you all know, in stock market Indonesia, the price is so affordable. You can buy a stock as little as 50 × 1 lot 100, 5000. So you can buy a company as low as 5000, but I do not recommend stock that have that low price. Maybe some higher up. Also, it protect your wealth from inflation, as we all know that inflation is a real thing, and rather than you need to look for investment that beat the inflation. If you invest in something that is lower than inflation rate, it means that you will lose money. For example, if you Indomie dulu berapa, 1000 ya, and then now it's 5000, so it's, if you're didn't work your money, you will lose money. So that's why. Also, the main reason, this is a reason why me and Vincent buy stock, it's make us proud, because we become the owner of the business that we invest in, especially the business that we love. There is a kebanggaan sendiri investasi ke perusahaan yang kita suka. Ya. Jadi, while investing sounds very hard, but sometimes it also can be very fun if you really putting your interest in your investment.
Yeah, if I may add, I have some funny stories between me and Adit back to 2019, where we were studying at Bardo's class, Financial Management 2, and we were discussing about stocks, we were discussing about property stocks and retail stocks. And at that time, we bought Agung Podomoro and Mitra Diperkasa. And then Adit said to me, "Hey Vincent, let's go shopping after this, because I want to celebrate that I will declare that this is my property." And that's the funny story. And yeah, one more thing is when you buy stocks, you can increase your prestige level and you can tell to your friend, maybe, hey, I am the owner of Sumareko and I am the owner of this mall. Yeah, that's the funny story.
Yeah, definitely. Especially it will be good for youngsters to brag to their potential girlfriend that you own a mall, you own a Starbucks. You can brag about that. So Vincent already mentioned this, the investing, we really encouraging everyone at any age to investing as early as possible. Vincent mentioned that when we are young, we have time, energy, and money. But as the time goes on, we don't have any energy, we have less time, and we cannot make money. So having an investment is really important, especially when we don't have any energy to and time to make money. We are not gonna talk about how to invest because I am the material, because Prof. Roy and next guest will tell you about that. And this is our experience, especially I will take an example when we are at IPMI. In our class with Pardo Duitanto on investment portfolio management, we have a project using our real money. We choose a sector, we choose a company, and this is one of the examples that we choose. We choose Antam. Aneka Tambang, if everyone know the gold, but no, Antam doesn't just sell gold, but they also have mining, nickel mining, and that is also one of the reason why we invest in Antam. At that time, as we all know, at May to April, we got hit by pandemic. It's the price stock goes down, and we buy the Antam at 820, and we close our portfolio at January. So it's around 2000-ish. We close our position, and we, as you all know, that we that mean we gain almost 100%.
Yeah.
And that's what we're proud of, and we thankful for the knowledge that IPMI gave us, and we also super we also discuss it together at our investment gallery. We also have other stocks such as Mayora, Breeze. We buy Breeze before the three company merge, the Sharia banking merge. So that is a good way to start our journey of investing. We believe that everyone can also experience what we experience. If you guys are willing to invest your time to get the knowledge, as Prof. Roy said, financial literacy, it's important, because as I see nowadays, many influencers give advice on investment while doesn't give the detail of how it's actually, if you just go in without any proper proper knowledge, it will you only gonna go down as fast as what they say.
Yeah,
this quote is by Benjamin Graham. Maybe Vincent can talk about it, because it's, I think it's very relate to Vincent.
Yeah, at this semester, we also have class with Ardo, the RFP class, the Registered Financial Planner class. And once I was searching about the quote, because Ardo said, hey, every one of you in this semester, the assignment, you have to help the investor club, and you have to making design for the Instagram. If you have any quote, you can tell to the group. And I was searching, and I met this quote, and it sounds like this. Successful investing is about managing risk, not avoiding it. Yes, it is true, because when we breathe in, when we wake up, when we do everything, when we do our activities, we face risk. And especially in investment, there are two R, which is risk and return, and risk always comes first. But we have to find the return. We have to gain the return as much as we can. And in the other side, we have to manage our risk. So if I may have speak in bahasa, mengoptimalkan hasil dengan meminimalisir risiko. Kenapa? Karena kalau tidak diminimalisir risikonya, yang di awalnya we hope for the return, tahu-taunya risiko yang datang kepada kita. Makanya ada namanya risk management di situ. Adit, do you want to add some?
Yeah, that is so true, yeah. So in investing there will be a risk. Tapi kalau kita bisa memanage risiko itu lebih baik. Dengan cara apa? Seperti yang Pak Prof Roy bilang ya, financial literacy itu penting. Karena kalau investasi sekedar mengejar keuntungan itu pasti akan berjalan ke apa namanya, ke arah yang kita tidak inginkan. Kayak yang di-share tadi, buy saat orang-orang sudah menerima keuntungan, kita baru ikut buy karena hype-nya itu masih ada, dan itu kita malah beli di pucuk gitu. Jadi ya, cuma nambahin itu aja. Mungkin waktunya udah hampir selesai ya. Ini yang terakhir, saya mau share juga untuk partisipan, boleh join us and follow us at hipme/investor, saya akan tuliskan di chat. Kita banyak kegiatan di situ, dari investor, market weekly review. Jadi tiap minggu kita akan review gimana stock market bersama partner IPMI ya, Cipta Dana Sekuritas Asia. Dan jika tertarik silahkan follow dan DM langsung, nanti akan dijawab, nanti kita bisa ngobrol-ngobrol jika berkenan untuk membuka akun di investment gallery, kita pasti akan bantu. Dan depan ya, Sen ya, kan ada tamu ya, Warren Buffett Asia. Jadi
ya, Warren Buffett Asia.
Ya, Captain. Siapa kalau ingin tahu silakan follow.
Ini bukunya nih, teman-teman.
Nah, itu tuh. Ada tuh bukunya Rising Above Financial Storm. Itu. Ditunggu deh, ya. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih teman-teman. Thank you.
Dari kita lagi ke Fikri. Silakan Fikri.
Okay, thank you so much, Kak Berman White and Kak Vincent, for sharing with us about your insightful story and quotes. Let's welcome our guest speaker, Mr. Ishfan Helmi. Long story short, Mr. Ishfan Helmi was IPMI BBA alumnus 2009. So without further ado, Mr. Ishfan, the time is yours.
Thank you, Kak Fikri, for the opening and to our distinguished Professor Roy Sembel, Ibu Yulita, and as well as Pak Sasotya and Ibu Sudrotu Naim. I really blessed of having a time here to share my experience and also my knowledge. So it's a very good session, very great sessions up to now. And I look at the session I bring my professor. It's a very, very insightful, as well as the learning experience just shared by Abdul Rahman and Kak Vincent. So it's just remind me of my time like 13 or 14 years ago when I start learning stock investment in 2008. So actually I'll share a little bit of my background here. So I was born in 88, so not that young anymore, but not that old as well. So I graduated from IPMI in 2009, and as well as now I'm serving as a VP head of research and one of the recognizable securities in Indonesia, OCBC securities owned by the OCBC group. They also have a banking, OCBC and ISP. So my career as a financial expertise here is not it's very related with my background in AFNI. So long story short, I learned, as I told you, I learned the stock investment in 2008, and I start my career as 2 years later, 2010, I start as an equity analyst. And maybe some of you will be surprised that within the space of 3 years, when I entered the career as investment analyst, 3 years I'll become the I'm heading a division with just 3 years of experience. So actually, this industry is really valued the intelligence of a person of the analyst itself. So so when this industry where only have like 15 to 100 securities in Indonesia, and people who tend to work want to work as analyst, as an investment analyst, as equity analyst is very small. So actually the supply itself, the supply for the employee, the demand for the employee itself is very small. So like nowadays, if you look at the current situation, most of the graduate want to work as a in a startup companies. They want to start their new business, but the intention to work as a stockbroker, as an investment analyst, is a very the demand is not that high. But I encourage more graduates to start to work in this industry because it's very promising. So actually, if you look at one of the quotes I remember in America, it's very famous. If for parents who wants to get their daughter married by someone, they will ask, "What is your boyfriend work job? If it's a pilot, if it's a lawyer, and the third one is a guy who work from Wall Street." If you watch movies like Wolf of Wall Street and etc., the image of working as Wall Street is a very exclusive. So actually, this is the field of works that I want more like from IBNI bachelor to graduate to work in this industry. It's very promising. And the other thing, if you work in this industry, is you can learn, you are close to the market, and you can hear the info, you can hear the insight of many people, so you can have a better investment journey. This is my profile, and if you have questions, you can ask me here. If my time is 15 minutes, I think. So the title of my presentation here is investing in a technology company. So actually, why I choose the topic of technology company here, I'm going to show you here the change of 2010 to 2020, the largest five largest company in the world. In 2010, largest company in the world is dominated by mostly like a petroleum company, a commodities company. But now 2020, the five largest came from technology stocks. So technology is the new commodities. Then next, I'm not going to talk many companies. I focus only two here. So Amazon, why Amazon is mungkin teman-teman kalau ingat Amazon itu sebenarnya dulu long ago they are not like e-commerce like now. They started the business as a bookstore, and now it has become a very large and the largest retail company in America is Amazon. Nah, ini to relate with our main topic, FIRE, financial independent and retire early. So here is the sample. Also related with what Professor Roy has told us about. Imagine, bayangkan tahun 97, if your parents have money around $100, just $100, buy the Amazon stock. Now, how much it will be worth? Itu kira-kira nilainya around kalau dirupiahkan di sini itu sekitar 3,5 miliar. Jadi bayangkan 1,5 juta zaman dulu tahun 97 kita belikan saham Amazon. Now you will have the inheritance, warisan dari orang tua Anda itu sekitar 3,5 miliar. This is how amazing the stock market works. So if you start investing, don't look at the 1 year, 2 year horizon, but you should think about 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, like what Warren Buffett had told us. So for those who doesn't know, Warren Buffett is the number one investor in the world, one of the richest investors. to start the journey only from stock investing. So returnnya berapa Amazon ini from 1997 itu sekitar 200,000%. So there's no other investment like this. If you find a good one and you ride it along the time. Just for the comparison, if tahun 97, if 97 your parents put $100 in time deposit, how much it will be worth right now? It's only $300. So it using the 5% annual return ya. Jadi this is the comparison why you should invest in the stock market. Nah, mungkin sedikit lecturing session here. Kenapa sih Amazon ini bisa performance sahamnya itu sebesar itu? Jadi my quote here is in the world of investment, revenue and the profit are the main engine of growth for stock price. Bayangkan tahun 2003 itu dia cuma 5 billion dia punya revenue. Sekarang itu sekitar hampir mendekati 400 billion in year ya. Jadi ini yang menyebabkan si Amazon ini kenapa harga sahamnya itu bisa naik terus. Jadi kita harus nyari saham-saham yang kayak gini yang kira-kira the next 20 year will be a boom or will be the next Amazon. So ini kalkulasi saya, kalau Anda punya uang $100 sekarang, Anda belikan saham Amazon di harga saat ini, harga market, tahun 2040 itu nilainya akan menjadi 3.000 atau bisa naik 30 kali lipat. So, kalau tadi tahun 97 $100-nya sekarang bisa jadi sekitar 3 miliar atau sekitar 200 ribuan dolar, kalau Anda beli sekarang, tahun 2040 Anda akan dapat $3,000, which is it's not bad compared to if you put your money on the time deposit, kan? Nah, this is... how I calculate, mungkin waktunya terlalu sedikit untuk menjelaskan cara-caranya. Intinya, this is how you will learn at IPMI. You will learn in a financial management class how to forecast the stock price, how to forecast the business itself. It's not very difficult, but it's not that simple as well. So take your time to learn the financial literacy. So this is the stock price of Amazon projection. I highlighted here yellow. Kalau sekarang itu harganya $3,200, itu nanti prediksinya 2030 itu bisa mencapai sekitar $16,000. Jadi ini hitungan menggunakan multiple valuation earnings. Jadi ini kira-kira proyeksi saham Amazon. Dan kalau kita lihat di sini, if you look at here, kalau tadi bertanya saham Amazon $3,000 tuh kalau dirupiahin berapa sih dikali aja 15.000 itu udah satu lembar aja itu sekitar 40 sampai 50 juta. Nah, pertanyaannya punya uang nggak segitu? Kalau gue cuma punya $10, gimana sih mau beli? Nanti saya akan jelasin ada caranya. Jadi sekarang itu ada namanya fractions of shares. Jadi tidak perlu beli satu lembar saham, tapi beberapa orang patungan membeli satu lembar saham gitu. Itu bisa nanti ada caranya saya jelaskan. Nah, next to find the next Amazon, di sini saya akan kasih contoh satu itu adalah Netflix. Why Netflix? Karena Netflix itu sudah memakan 15% dari total kuota bandwidth internet selama pandemi. Jadi artinya orang-orang sekarang udah nggak ke bioskop, orang semua nonton Netflix. Dan if you look at here, Amazon dari tahun 97 return 200,000%, Netflix baru 50,000%. Artinya kalau to replicate Amazon, kita masih punya 150,000% lagi yang bisa di-chase over the next 20 years. Jadi ini kira-kira sedikit sejarah Amazon itu dulu dia cuma hanya tukang rental DVD. Kita skip langsung next. Nah, Amazon's value market capitalization is now is larger than Disney. Jadi Disney itu it's old fashion business, dia punya Disney Hotstar baru launching karena mau niru Netflix. Dan if you look at here, kenapa Netflix itu larger than Disney in terms of market capitalization? Ternyata
mengenai
net profitnya juga itu sudah melebihi Disney ekspektasi di tahun 2021. Artinya di sini labanya udah besar dari bisnis. Jadi this is the new treasure lah kira-kira. Jadi mungkin aku sedikit jelasin di sini sedikit tentang valuasi. Jadi ketika sebuah perusahaan startup yang tadinya rugi tiba-tiba dia jadi untung, itu market bisa menghargai dia 100 kali dari dia punya earnings atau 100 kali dari dia punya laba bersih, which is compared to average market itu hanya 20 to 30 times of earnings. Jadi ini nanti kita biasanya diajarin nanti di financial management class. Nah, ini sedikit bocoran Netflix if you interested here. Sekarang harganya sekitar $600, proyeksi saya 2030 itu bisa jadi $4,000. Artinya masih ada return hampir 5-6 kali lipat masih ada lah untuk the next 10 years. Jadi mungkin sedikit quote dari Warren Buffett juga di sini, you don't need to be rocket scientist in investing, but investing is not a game where 160 IQ beats 130 degree investing. Itu yang penting you punya financial literacy dan you punya kesabaran dan disiplin. Nah, si Netflix ini kalau punya uang 100 dolar di IPO 2002, sekarang berapa nilainya? Itu 60 ribu dolar atau 1 miliar. Jadi bayangkan 1,5 juta itu bisa jadi uang sekitar 1 miliar dalam kurun waktu less than 20 years. Saya sebenarnya in my opinion itu kayak my father, my mother, my parents itu udah, kenapa sih dari dulu nggak get to know the stock market? Kenapa nggak dari dulu udah mulai investasi? Karena dengan investasi zaman dulu sampai sekarang pasti kita punya uang lebih banyak daripada sekarang. Jadi kalau orang zaman dulu biasanya taruhnya di emas, deposito dan lain-lain, belum tahu namanya saham. Jadi with new generation harusnya we can benefit from this and we can be richer, ever richer than the age of our parents. Nah, tahun 2007 kalau you beli Netflix, Anda beli Netflix, maka sekarang nilainya berapa itu 20 ribu dolar atau masih ada, bayangin aja 2.000% return-nya. Artinya it's never too late to buy a stock, it's never too late to invest in the stock market. Hitungannya sekarang saya kasih, kalau if you buy $100 now in Netflix, by 2014 kalau tadi si Amazon itu cuma 3.000-an dolar, Netflix hitungan saya bisa ngasih return lebih dua kali dari Amazon, jadi masih bisa dapat $6.000 by 2014. Bayangin kalau each month you invest just $100, then just calculate how many months until 2014, dan 6.000 ini tinggal dikali berapa. Jadi investasi itu you need to be consistent with all the money you get monthly you invest, then you will see 20 years from now, 30 years from now itu akan jadi berapa. Nah, ini mungkin sedikit sejarah dari Netflix, you can read. Nah, ini sekarang tentang aplikasi yang tadi saya bilang bahwa fraction of shares, kalau cuma punya $100 bisa ngasih beli Netflix, bisa. Di mana itu ada salah satu yang terpercaya namanya GoTrade, itu Malaysian based. Jadi di Malaysia itu dia menyediakan online trading untuk bisa beli saham-saham stok di Amerika atau di US gitu. Nah, jadi mungkin tadi pada nanya kan, mungkin pada berpikir kok ngomongnya saham US sih nggak ngomong Indonesia. Jadi mungkin the technology company in Indonesia now itu sama seperti mirip dengan kondisi teknologi stock di US pada saat early tahun 2000. Artinya the next year mungkin ada Bukalapak udah IPO, akan ada Tokopedia, terus Gojek Tokopedia gabung kan, terus ada Traveloka, ada yang lain-lain. Jadi di sini mungkin aku saya sedikit jelaskan, kalau tadi Anda nggak mau langsung trading saham US, Anda juga bisa beli reksadana US. Jadi dalam reksadana berbasis equity US ini dari BNP Paribas itu dia punya isinya kayak Alphabet, itu Google ya, Apple, terus ada Visa, ada Procter & Gamble, jadi Microsoft juga ada. Jadi saham-saham teknologi di mix masuk di sini, cuman di sini modalnya lebih besar, artinya butuh $10.000 untuk membuka si reksadana saham yang underlyingnya saham-saham Amerika.
Nah,
ini next-nya tadi yang saya bilang, perusahaan, kira-kira kalau perusahaan-perusahaan startup teknologi kayak gini, Gojek, Tokopedia, Bukalapak, Traveloka, itu Anda mau beli nggak? Mungkin kalau nanti bisa diskusi dengan Kak Abdurrahman Wahid dan Kak Vincent juga ya, bisa kita bisa sharing. Nah, mungkin kalau teman-teman lihat di sini, berita-berita bahwa laporan keuangan Bukalapak itu jelek, dia rugi 1,3 triliun. Pendapatan beban untuk administrasi, beban untuk pemasaran 1,3 triliun, 1,4 triliun. Jadi memang seperti yang tadi saya bilang di awal, bahwa when the technology company turning into profit, market otomatis akan menilai dia up to 100 times of earning. Jadi kita tinggal tunggu. If you invest in Bukalapak now, kita akan tunggu kapan perusahaan itu untung, dan ketika dia untung, itu larinya itu udah nggak ketulungan seperti yang terjadi di Amazon. Jadi This is remind me of what happened at Amazon and Netflix ketika tahun 2000-an awal. People never think itu akan jadi sebuah booming stock, tapi the next 20 years it has become one of the largest company in the world. Nah, juga di sini alasannya kenapa we have to invest in Indonesia juga. Jadi dengan masuknya saham-saham teknologi di Indonesia, mudah-mudahan ini akan hype-nya juga akan besar, dan ini prediksi bahwa 2030 ekonomi Indonesia itu akan jadi the fifth largest in the world. In the world itu hanya kalah dari India, China, Amerika, dan Jepang. Nah, sekarang kalau ngomongin Bukalapak tadi saya sedikit nyambungin bahwa Bukalapak itu udah masuk salah satu largest holding dari aset manajemen Indonesia. Saya ambil contoh di sini reksadana Schroder itu buka IJ di sini, Bukalapak itu udah menjadi fourth largest holding dari si Schroders punya reksadana ini. Dia hanya kalah dari BRI, BCA, dan Mandiri. Di bawahnya ada Mayora, ada Merdeka Cooper, terus ada Multi Bintang, Telkom, Sido Muncul, dan Vale Indonesia. Jadi memang Bukalapak ini udah mulai masuk banyak di portfolio dari aset manajemen, dan mereka itu berharap bahwa when it turns to profit, harganya akan lari kemana-mana, bisa return 50% setahun, itu udah gampang. Then next di sini, mungkin sedikit summary dari saya, four basic way to earn money, tadi mungkin udah dijelaskan oleh profesor juga bahwa selling your time, kita work as employee, making money on interest, kita taruh uang di time deposit, terus generating profit from business, kita punya business, sama generating profit from our mobile phone. Jadi ini yang paling menarik, generating profit from our mobile phone. Gimana sih caranya? Ini saya jelasin di sini caranya. Yang pertama ya, kalau teman-teman tahu ada namanya dropshipping, terus habis itu ada stock investment. Semua sekarang belinya lewat apa namanya, lewat handphone. Bayangkan jari Anda itu bisa menghasilkan ribuan dolar. Terus kemudian dua ini yang menurut saya agak sedikit misperception in the market, itu banyak sekali orang yang menilai bahwa saham itu lama, saham itu lemot, harus tunggu bertahun-tahun. Orang pengen langsung cuan apa profit 50%. Larinya kemana? Larinya ke kripto, terus kemudian ke forex. Tapi jangan salah bahwa di dua investasi ini, di dua investment ini, Anda bisa kehilangan seluruh aset yang Anda masukkan. Jadi memang ini very risky, dan if you don't have enough knowledge, jangan sekali-sekali jebur di sini. Karena sekarang banyak sekali yang salah tuh anak-anak muda pada ngikutin ini, katanya dijual investasi udah pakai robot, kita nggak perlu mantau, tapi sekali robotnya default, Anda nggak bisa nutup si perusahaan pembuat robotnya tersebut. Jadi memang financial literacy itu sangat penting ketika Anda memulai journey as investor. Dan untuk berikutnya ini ada quote lagi dari Warren Buffett, risk comes from not knowing what you are doing. Jadi apapun yang kita lakukan, investasi apapun, kita harus tahu. Paling nggak tadi kita belajar company-nya, kita tahu owner-nya siapa, bisnisnya apa, dan prospek ke depannya seperti apa. Jadi mungkin itu. Dan terakhir, ini adalah disclaimer. Jadi mungkin saya sedikit jelasin pekerjaan saya di kantor, bahwa semua yang kita omongin itu adalah, kita dilindungi secara hukum oleh disclaimer. Artinya apa yang kita bilang ini bukan saran atau apa namanya wejangan untuk Anda ikut investasi, Anda beli saham itu. Tapi kita dilindungi oleh disclaimer ini bahwa apa yang kita bilang mungkin terjadi dan mungkin saja tidak terjadi, dan dilindungi secara hukum, dan kita semua lakukan based on analysis. Jadi itu sih mungkin dari aku, waktunya juga udah hampir habis, jadi kita lanjut ke sesi Q&A. Mungkin kalau banyak yang pertanyaan, silahkan untuk bertanya. Kalau kita masih punya sesi Q&A, saya kembalikan lagi. Thank you very much, it's a blast for me to share my experience as a ICMI alumni. Saya kembalikan ke Kak Fikri, thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ishfan, for a very good presentation and session. Before we continue to the next session, we'll have a mini game session first. For the top three winner who win this game, this session, the which is a game session, will get a special present from us, which are a cash that will be sent to your OVO, GoPay, or Dana account, and a lovely goodie bag that will be sent directly to your house. Please claim your present by contacting Katami. There are her contact. Will be shown in the screen, but we will wait for a while. The technician is processing now. And don't forget, when you're joining a game, please choose your real name when you're joining. So, are you ready, guys? This session will be led by Ms. Lisa Nello. With all respect, the time is yours, Ms. Lisa.
Hello. Thank you, Fikri, and thank you for all the speakers and all the participants who are still joining us for today. Now we will proceed to the game session. Maybe Fikri, you may add, for those who have given the very interesting questions would be given like the merchandise from IPMI as well. Then the other, you will have the opportunity to win this game. Okay. You will have the opportunity to win this game and win the prize as mentioned by Fikri. Don't forget to put your real name. Yeah. Don't forget to put your real name. If you are winning this game, then you can claim to Kak Tami by screenshot that you have win the prize. All right. So, where is the game? For sharing, okay, just join kahoot.id, then the pin game as mentioned in the chat box, which is 4680672 468-0672. Okay, go to kahoot.it, then the pin game would be 4680672. So have you joined the Kahoot already? Already. So how many, Lisa, we have? Okay, we have 12 so far. Come on, guys. You can have the opportunity to win the prize. All right. So we have Stanley. Oh, similar to my son's name. Okay. Wahid, Krista, Elia, Isfan, Gita, Eugene, Vijayanpura, Valentina. Oh, we have Kak Bagawan. Okay. Catherine, Teguh, Freddy. All right. Only 13. Come on. I need maybe 20 over here. Then I will start. Okay. Bagawan.
Miss, wait for me, miss.
All right. Come on. Okay. That's the game pin. Warren Buffett. Who's Warren Buffett? All right. So don't forget, if you want to claim the game, then you have to put the real name, yeah? Yeah, just put the real name because the winners should claim by screensharing by yourself. Okay, so we have Ewan Johnson. Vincent. Vincent is here. All right. Steven. All right, Warren Buffett, maybe you still have a time to rename yourself. All right, okay. So we have already 20 participants in joining the game. So are you ready? All right. So
I'm ready, miss.
Ready, yeah, Vincent? Okay, so, okay, we have money. Yeah. All right, so we will start the session soon. Okay, Lisa, you may click the start and we will start the game. Okay, this is the mini game. 3, 2, 1. What is this? Okay, that's very easy, yeah? This is our professor for today's webinar. Okay, is he Prof. Roy Sample or Prof. Aman Wirakarta Kusuma as our executive director? Wow, all right. Okay, good. So Warren Buffett is number one. Okay, who's Warren Buffett? Okay. Opit, okay, Kak Opit is here. Now, second one. What is the title of today's webinar? Now, is it Financial Independence Retire Early? True or false? Okay. Quite easy, yeah? Come on, guys. There are 21 participants. Should be one person who wrong to answer, but 17 is correct. Still one Warren Buffett? Ah, Bagawan. Okay, number two is Erin, and then Mani, Kak Opit, Alvin. Okay, next, BBS stands for? Okay, the BBS stands for? Come on. Wow, number 16, only 16, so there are two wrong guess. It's okay, next. Bagawan again. Okay. Seems like Bagawan will win the prize, yeah? Okay, next. Krista is Yummy. Yeah. Here. See the flyer, guys. See the flyer. Oh, okay. BBA Alumni 2009. Is it correct, yeah? Kak Isfan, yeah? So win the game. So far, Bagawan will win the GoPay and OVO. Okay, next one. True or false? BBA Pro Class is open for all ages. True or false? Wow, 13 students. Yeah, so BBA is only for minimum 22, yeah, Pasas, yeah? Minimum 22 of ages, so not for all ages. So, Bagawan, still on the top of the scoreboard. Okay, please, next. Who do we have here? So, if student would like to learn more about stock market and its review, then you can join. Okay, I think Kak Abu Rahman and Vincent have explained it clearly, yeah? Yeah, good. Yeah, who says InnoLab? Okay, so it's investment gallery. Still, Kak Bagawan, win the prize.
All right, so next, what do we have here? If students would like to start their own business, then they can join the investment gallery or financial management or in the lab. Okay, good. Yeah, so if you want to start your own business, then you can join our Inno Lab at IPMI. Okay, good one. Next, yeah, who is the winner so far? Yeah, still IPMI folks over here, Bagawan, Koopit, and Wahid. All right, next. Okay, I think this is the last question, yeah. Who is our MC today? Is it Kak Fitri, Kak Amin, or me as the MC? Who is the MC for today? Alright, yeah. Yeah, one is answering my name. Okay. Thank you so much. Then, who is the podium and the winner? Okay, Kak Opit, congratulations. Then, Kak Wahid, number one, I think the only one, Bagawan. Kak Bagawan win the prize. Okay, congratulations. So, just straight up, then you can... you can claim to Pak Tami, okay, yeah, if you want to win the prize for the mini question. Then I will go back to Kak Fitri to continue the session. Thank you so much, everybody.
Okay, congratulations for the winners. Yay! So, okay, let me see here. Are you ready, guys? I do believe most of the participants probably have a question to ask because of it. So I will open the Q&A session. First, I see the question from Anggita Aninditya. Izin bertanya, bagaimana pandangan Bapak Ishwan mengenai fenomena anak muda saat ini yang berinvestasi di kripto, tetapi gajinya masih terbilang kecil, sekitar 1 sampai dengan 3 juta rupiah dan berharap untung di kripto dapat menjadi tabungan. Fenomena ini banyak di desa-desa dan ikut-ikutan. Okay, maybe I will give a stage to Mr. Ishwan Helmi. So sir, the time is yours.
Thank you. Jadi very good question. Jadi memang seperti yang tadi saya bilang bahwa kripto ini mungkin yang satu yang saya highlight adalah investasi kripto ini tidak dijamin oleh OJK. Yang pertama harus teman-teman ketahui seperti itu. Jadi memang aplikasi memang banyak, seperti ada kayak Binomo atau apalah yang sering muncul iklannya di YouTube atau di Google. Tapi ternyata memang selain itu tidak dijamin OJK, itu kalau ada beberapa mungkin yang kayak ada kayak Indodax atau apalah company-nya, itu kalau ditanya dijamin di mana, itu dijamin di Bappebti, itu di bawah Departemen Perdagangan. Jadi Anda dianggap sebagai pedagang, kalau barang Anda hilang ya udah dibawa ke broker, ya udah nggak ditanggung sama OJK. Jadi ini yang mungkin yang banyak orang-orang tidak ketahui. Nah, kalau balik ke fenomena yang gajinya cuma 1 juta 2 juta, investasi 1 juta 2 juta masuk kripto, ya mungkin bagi mereka it's nothing to lose. Jadi 1 juta kalau hilang semua pun nggak masalah, mereka masih punya ada sisa gaji yang lain. Cuman ya saya sayangkan adalah the loss of opportunity. Ketika bayangkan kalau uang itu Anda tabung masukin ke stock market, Anda misalnya beli saham Bukalapak yang misalnya sekarang cuma 800 rupiah, bisa jadi the next 5 years, 10 years bisa jadi 10.000 rupiah. Itu kan memang the loss of opportunity ketika Anda main crypto. You play for the short term, you're looking for the 1 day 2 day 3 days gain. Sedangkan in the short period juga Anda bisa kehilangan semuanya. Jadi memang sangat disayangkan sekali. Kenapa? Karena edukasi literasi dari kripto itu sendiri juga memang sangat sangat masif sekali, dan iklannya juga di mana-mana, di Instagram banyak orang yang mulai main kripto. Jadi memang kalau saya pribadi lebih baik kita mengkotakkan diri di stock investment dan kita fokus untuk long term value, bukan dari short term gain. Jadi memang kalau punya uang segitu mungkin boleh saja, sah-sah saja untuk mencoba, tapi ada baiknya kalau portfolio kita itu lebih besar di saham. Anggaplah dari 2 juta misalnya, 1,5 juta di saham, 500 ribu di kripto, itu nggak masalah. Artinya kalau 500 ribu hilang, ya istilahnya uang jajan kopi hilang gitu. Tapi kalau di saham ini kita nabung bukan just for ourselves, saham itu bisa jadi legacy seperti yang saya jelaskan tadi, bahwa $100 tahun 97 itu bisa jadi 3 miliar saat ini kalau orang tua kita dulu beli saham Amazon di Amerika. Jadi memang it's a powerful of compounding, sehingga menurut saya saham itu tidak akan tergantikan sepanjang masa. 100 tahun lagi saham itu tetap ada, Wall Street tetap buka, dan harusnya ini kita jadikan saham ini sebagai inheritance, artinya anak-anak kita, cucu-cucu kita semua nanti pada saat waktunya kita ajarkan tentang saham, dan kita jadikan ini sebagai akun yang dimiliki oleh keluarga, dan sampai 3 generasi, 7 generasi itu bisa jadi miliuner, billioner, bahkan triliuner dari saham yang diwariskan dari beberapa generasi di atas. Jadi itu sih mungkin yang karena hype dari social media, hype dari apa namanya YouTuber-YouTuber mulai main kripto, jadi memang ini memang kita lihat bahwa banyak orang yang main kripto, dan kita tunggu aja 5 tahun ke depan itu kripto boleh nggak, karena setahu saya kayak di Singapura, China itu udah nge-ban cryptocurrency, artinya Anda bisa main cryptocurrency tapi hanya sebatas in your monitor, nggak bisa dipakai di dunia nyata untuk transaksi. Jadi memang China dan Singapura itu udah nge-ban cryptocurrency, jadi ke depan kalau semakin banyak negara yang nge-ban cryptocurrency, artinya kalau itu cuma jadi paper apa namanya monitor aset doang, aset di komputer doang, mau buat apa dia akan bertahan sampai 10 tahun. Jadi memang underlying asetnya nggak ada seperti itu. Jadi mungkin itu sih jawaban dari saya. Semoga bisa menjawab.
Okay, thanks so much, Mr. Ivan, for the insightful response. Probably I'm still waiting for you guys. Kalau ada yang masih mau bertanya, we are very open. Please chat on the chat box. Put in your question on the chat box with the format, your name, underscore for whom the question is addressed to, and underscore your question. Okay, probably I will add, Mr. Ishfan, I have a question personally. Kira-kira, what's your point of view, sir? Atau bagaimana your suggestion as a investor yang pemula, sir? Kira-kira yang paling sering kesalahannya itu di sebelah mana, sir? And then, bagaimana kita bisa supaya tidak jatuh di lubang yang orang banyak jatuh itu, sir?
Oke. Jadi mungkin pertanyaannya sangat berbobot sekali. Jadi memang yang pertama yang harus dipunyai investor itu adalah mental yang kuat. Mental yang kuat artinya terkadang misalnya Anda beli saham, terus habis itu sahamnya turun. Terus Anda cut loss, habis Anda cut loss sahamnya malah lari naik. Jadi itu memang pertama harus punya mental. Artinya kalau kita yakin company itu bagus, kita harus pegang itu meskipun harganya turun. Karena penurunan itu adalah market correction itu wajar. Tapi di jangka panjang yang dilihat itu adalah value fundamental dari si perusahaan tersebut. Itu kesalahan yang pertama dilakukan adalah ketika rugi kita harus nge-realize, kita cut loss, kita pindah saham lainnya, saham lainnya nggak naik, saham yang tadinya kita jual malah udah rebound balik. Jadi itu kesalahan yang paling banyak dilakukan. Yang kesalahan yang kedua adalah kita terlalu overtrade, artinya kita terlalu banyak trading tuh. Artinya hari ini kita beli saham A, besok bisa kelam saham B, saham C, saham D, dan resiko kita udah widespread, dan ternyata ketika kita tarik return-nya itu malah biasa-biasa saja. Jadi saya lebih suka di sini adalah focus investment. Artinya kalau kita udah menemukan satu saham yang bagus, kita yakin untuk holding period kita itu 20 years, 30 years, ya, setiap bulan kita belikan. Misalnya kayak contoh di Indonesia, tadi saya nggak bahas, mungkin ada perusahaan kayak Sido muncul misalnya yang memang secara fundamental bagus, dan saya cukup yakin sampai 10 years itu harganya masih, trajektorinya masih naik. Kalau sekarang harga 800, mungkin bisa 1.000, 2.000, 3.000, sampai 5.000. Jadi kita beli tiap bulan. Kita beli tiap bulan dari uang yang kita, dan kita harus yakin. Jadi kalau mengutip Warren Buffett, kalau teman-teman lihat bukunya itu, invest like a girl. Jadi kita harus investasi itu, menganggap investasi itu kayak wanita. Artinya kalau kita udah suka, kita udah proposal marriage to someone, kita akan stick to the investasi tersebut. Dan kayak Warren Buffett, kayak dia punya Coca-Cola sampai sekarang dari tahun 88 dia beli, dia nggak dijual. Jadi memang salah satu kesalahan yang harus dihindari adalah jangan terlalu berganti-ganti saham, dan kita fokus pada saham yang kita pilih. Dan kuncinya yang pertama adalah kita harus melakukan research mendalam sebelum kita yakin. Istilahnya kayak ada orang pacaran tuh ada PDKT-nya, sampai yakin propose married, ketemu orang tuanya. Kalau di saham kita ketemu sama manajemennya, kita lihatlah profil manajemennya seperti apa, dan kita invest, kita beli tiap bulan dari income kita beli, sampai nanti kita akan lihat pohon kita. Kalau di bursa itu biasanya yuk nabung saham, kita akan lihat pohon kita itu saham semakin besar karena kita pupuk dengan tiap bulan kita investasi. Jadi mungkin itu sih sedikit jawaban dari pertanyaan Kak Fikri tadi.
Baik, terima kasih Pak Ivan. Ini ada satu pertanyaan lagi. Ya. Come on guys, I think semuanya mungkin kalau yang curious boleh langsung tanya, karena for your information, Miss Lisa mentioned before, for the best questioner will get a present from us also. Oke, ini ada dari Bapak Irfan nih. Izin bertanya Bapak, bagaimana dengan berinvestasi di aplikasi seperti Bibit atau Ajaib? Apakah aman untuk kedepannya?
Oke, langsung saya jawab ya. Jadi kalau bibit dan ajaib itu memang sudah dijamin OJK dan terdaftar di OJK. Jadi karena isinya di bibit dan ajaib itu adalah saham, kalau bibit itu kebanyakan reksadana. Jadi kalau tadi saya sempat mention, kalau mau punya exposure di reksadana itu bisa pakai juga di bibit. Kalau ajaib itu adalah sekuritas juga, jadi aplikasi untuk trading saham, untuk beli jual saham juga. Jadi kedepannya sih aman. Jadi karena dia sudah dapat logo terdaftar di OJK, maka itu sudah dikatakan itu aman. Jadi jangan sampai kita berinvestasi di sesuatu yang belum dijamin oleh OJK. Cuman kalau tadi yang tadi saya sempat mention tadi Heigo Trade di depan, kalau mau beli US fractional itu memang tidak terdaftar di OJK, belum OJK belum dia belum mendaftar di OJK, tapi di situ dia terdaftar di SEC, itu Securities Exchange Commission di USA. Jadi karena si Heigo Trade bekerjasama dengan salah satu securities di company di Amerika, dan securities company di Amerika itu terdaftar langsung di SEC atau kayak OJK-nya Amerika. Jadi memang masing-masing kita akan lihat, kayak misalnya if you invest in the US stock ya dijamin oleh SEC, if you invest in Indonesian stock dijamin oleh OJK gitu. Jadi sejauh ada logo terdaftar di OJK maka itu aman. Gitu jawaban dari saya.
Oke, baik, terima kasih Pak Ishfan. Lalu mungkin ada satu pertanyaan terakhir. We are very sorry setelahnya karena we have a limit of time. Ini ada dari Catherine. Mungkin Pak, kalau misalkan we are talking about saham, some is orientation is orang yang sudah punya active income. Lalu bagaimana kalau misalkan pelajar SMA, Pak? Apakah bisa berinvestasi juga?
Sebenarnya gini, jadi pelajar SMA, anak-anak zaman SMA sekarang kan uang jajannya lumayan tuh. Ada sepupu saya uang jajannya dikasih 100 juta di apa namanya di rekening dari bapaknya ngasih gitu kan. Jadi ketimbang uangnya dipakai untuk main game atau hura-hura ngopi kayak Kak Abdurrahman Wahid tadi bilang, dia nggak suka yang ngopi-ngopi gitu kan, lebih baik investasi. Jadi sebaiknya uang dari uang jajan tersebut kita investasikan. Artinya ketika uang itu misalnya awal tahun kita dikasih misalnya 10 juta, kalau kita investasi dulu, nanti ketika mau butuh baru kita tarik ya, end of the year bisa jadi 15 juta, bisa jadi 20 juta. Jadi sebenarnya dari uang jajan pun kita udah bisa mulai belajar investasi kecil-kecilan. Jadi kalau nggak sampai sejuta ya misalnya dikasih 500 ribu, ya 100 ribu kita coba buka lah misalnya. Karena kayak tadi misalnya contoh si saham Sido muncul itu satu lot itu sekitar 80 ribu. Jadi bisa beli dengan uang 80 ribu udah bisa punya satu lot saham Sido muncul. Jadi investasi itu kita mulai dari kecil-kecil aja deh, yang penting kita belajar, learning prosesnya itu yang harus kita lihat. Jadi kalau banyak orang bilang, oh investasi ada uang sekolahnya, uang sekolah itu apa sih? Uang sekolah itu kayak udah pernah rugi belum dari investasi, itu sih mungkin. Jadi supaya kita nggak kejebak membayar uang sekolah dari kerugian, kita harus belajar, tingkatkan financial literasi kita, dan kita harus pilih benar-benar di saham yang kita yakin dan fundamentalnya sangat bagus. Dan mungkin related sedikit, kalau ini ada tadi pertanyaan dari Pak Teguh juga, itu gimana sih investasi forex futures? Tadi saya highlight ulang lagi ya, bahwa forex futures tidak dijamin OJK, tapi dijamin oleh Bapak. Jadi apapun yang terjadi di sana, Anda loss, Anda disuruh top up, Anda disuruh macam-macam, itu udah di luar ranah OJK gitu. Jadi kalau uang hilang 100% itu bisa terjadi di sana. Tapi kalau saham, di saham itu ada batas bawahnya auto rejection, namanya auto rejection bawah, itu artinya dalam sehari tidak mungkin turun lebih dari 7%. Tapi kalau naik bisa sehari sampai 25%. Jadi saham itu lebih aman dan lebih terregulasi. Artinya kalau sehari turun 7% maksimum, lebih dari itu tidak akan dibiarkan oleh otoritas untuk turun. Jadi batasnya cuma sampai 7%. Jadi keamanan di saham itu sangat-sangat bagus. Artinya if you lost 7, batasnya udah dibatasi 7%. Jadi kita cuma punya potensi kehilangan maksimum 7% dari portfolio value kita di single day. Jadi itu mungkin bedanya. Tapi kalau di futures, forex Anda bisa kehilangan all your money within just a single second. Aja sih mungkin jawaban saya.
Baik, thank you so much Pak Ishfan. Thank you all for the question and answer. And also I want to remind for all the participants, don't forget to fulfill the feedback form that already attached on the chat box. Also, I want to inform you that for all of you that have attended this webinar, you will have a free ticket of gold submission, so you don't have to pay, and you can contact Kak Jo and Kak Ami for further information. Okay, before we end today's event, there's a closing remark from the Deputy Head of BBA Program and Mentor of Inalab, IPMI International Business School, Mr. Insinyur Sasotya. To Mr. Sasotya, the time is yours, sir.
Thank you, Fikri. Thank you also to all participants. Yeah, guys, thank you for attending this event. Yeah, we do hope that the sessions delivered by Pak Isfan, Pak Roy, Abdurrahman Wahid, and Vincent will be beneficial for you and also for us. And then just to have a comment to the speakers, what deliver are very interesting, very enticing, guys, that they talk about financial literacy, financial literacy, how to manage your assets and your cash, then, managing those assets and cash money doesn't mean that you have to invest, to invest or not to invest is, that's the question actually, but you can also not investing, to get that, say, financial freedom, but, it's up to you, okay? So, the financial literacy will lead you to a financial freedom, and financial freedom will lead you to your freedom, freedom to choose what you like to do, when you reach 40 years old, maybe, or 50 years old, then if you have this financial freedom, then you can choose your job, whatever you like. If you don't like the job, just quit, and that's all, right? If you have this kind of financial freedom. Okay, guys, that's all I think from the speaker. Also, thank you to Pak Isfan Helmi for your answer. It was very nice, about this crypto and other things. Guys, and I think that's all. Thank you very much again, guys, and hope that we can see you in IPMI or in other session. Don't forget about IPMI. Thank you and bye.
Okay, that is all from us. Thank you, Mr. Saswati, for the closing remarks. I want to apologize for any mistake. Thank you to Ms. Yulita, Ms. Riva, Ms. Drotunain, Ms. Lizanello, Mr. Sasotia, Prof. Sambel, all the lecture, Mr. Isfan, all the speaker and committee, and all, of course, all the participants. Thank you for joining our enrichment class today. See you all in the next IPMINAR, or looking forward to join our IPMI DBA program. Stay healthy, safe, productive, and innovative. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Have a good Saturday.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you so much. Thank you all. Thank you, the committee. Thank you so much, students.
Thank you, Pak Isfan.
Thank you, Pak Sas.
Thank you, Pak.
Thank you, Wahid. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pak Isfan, for telling us about the robot, Pak Isfan.
Thank you, Pak.
Banyak.
It's good to share.
Ikutan robot, coy.
Salam kenal ya, Pak Isfan.
What session?
Great session. Thank you so much. Thank you, Ibu Yulita. Thank you all.